Hey guys, we were gonna do a song for the intro for this movie, but I'm not good with lyrics, so I think instead we'll just take a song from Aqua Teen Hunger Force: colon, Movie Film Fright Theaters. Yeah. Clyde's channel. If I find you scolding on eBay, I will break into your house and tear your wife in half.
You called me at 4 in the morning to bring me all the way out here to your house just to do this? Pretty much, yeah. All right. The freaking sweet collection. Ooh. All right.
The annual.
Oh, I got a notification on my laptop or something. All right. Ah, I got a message from Jibby Bibble. Hey, Clyde, meet me at Junction. Again? Okay, I'm gonna see what Jibby Bibble wants. All right. I guess I'll go.
Thank you.
So you wanted me to meet you here?
Yeah, I've come to talk to you a little bit about Blaze.
Okay, what about him?
Well, I can't tell you much, but can you, like, tell him that I want to break up with him?
What? Why?
I'll tell you more later, but let's just say that I found someone else.
Yeah, I'll tell him.
Thanks. But yeah, me and him are done. Anyway, I'll meet you later, and I'll tell you more about what's going on.
Okay.
Oh, hold on. That's him. I better go.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Okay. Now, where is it? Oh, jeez. I'm getting a little hungry. I guess I better, find something to eat, I guess. Whoops. Gingerbread house. Lots of stuff. Yeah. It's a nice day outside. It's supposed to be 65 today. 65. Bob's Burgers is on. What the? What is that? Ah. Oh well. Little tiny cat. Little cat. Little cat. This is what I do in my spare time. Yeah. Little kitty cat. Yeah. I want to hear you roar. Yeah. Kitty cat. Roar. Oh, I don't know why I do stuff like this. Little kitty cat. Come out from under the Christmas tree. Come and eat my face. I want you to eat my face. I want you to eat my face. Come and eat my face. You come and eat my face. Like a little tropic cave. Do 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 do. Yeah, I'm upstairs going. Ooh, ooh, ooh. 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 Yeah.
Having a nice time, Clyde?
What? Jimmy Bibble, what are you doing here?
Sorry to disturb you on, short notice, but have you told Blaze about the thing yet?
Told Blaze! Whoa!
Blaze! Clyde!
What?
Look, I like your sense of humor. I like...
Sorry, excuse me.
I like your sense of humor and all. But you can't be like this all the time. I am serious, okay? You... It's about to stink up in here. Will you be serious, please? I want to break up with Blaze. Sorry, jeez. I wish sometimes you would be serious. You can't... Have you not been serious for once in your life? I've been serious. Look, I'm serious about licking this door. I'm serious about throwing myself. Well, looks like it's time for me to go then. See you later, Clyde. Wait! Wait! That's not the door. Where's the front door? There's the front door. What does she mean? I can't be like this all the time. It's my personality. I mean, I'm Clyde. It's what I do. My name is Clyde, and I like humor. This is my humor. I like to fart. Yes, I'm Clyde. I love to fart. Farting is my individuality. I like to eat many foods, especially when it's eggs. I like eggs, so many eggs. Oh, I like to eat some eggs. That's gas, so much gas. I have some gassy humor. I mean, how could you not laugh at that? It's good, good humor. It's 4:04 o'clock. 4:04 o'clock. I like meowing like a cat. Meow, 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 meow. I got money from YouTube because of its my humor. I like ceiling fans. I love them good. It's just my individuality. I like Christmas. Christmas time. I can't help myself. Hello, Santa. You know what I want for Christmas? You know what I want for Christmas? It's for JB Bagel to fall in love with me. That's all I want for Christmas. That's all I want for... Ow! Ow! Oh! Oh! I just tripped over my leg. Ugh. 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 I mean, come on. I'm Clyde. Serious is not my thing. I can't be serious. Not once. I mean, I'm Clyde Ellickson. It's not who I am. I'm a weird person. Being normal is overrated. Just is. I mean, people like my sense of humor. I mean, sure, if I was serious, I'd probably have a lot more subscribers. But Super Mario Logan, they started out the same way. They're comedy, full-on comedy. And they started out with, 20 subscribers for, 7 months. And then they started building up and building up. Plus, I can be serious sometimes. There's the Woods of Death. I mean, sure, my videos aren't that good, but... Being normal is overrated. Sure, if I was a serious guy, there would be a lot more subscribers, probably. But that's just not who I am. Nope. I'm a Mickey Mouse! Say, how could you not laugh at this? My humor! I mean, sure, I can be over the top sometimes. But it's just who I am. And I ain't changing a freaking thing. Not one thing, mother. But who's at the door? Huh?
Hey, Clyde.
Oh, hey, Blaze. Why are you here?
Juvie Bibble said that there was something important that you wanted to tell me.
No. I don't think so.
Well, she told me you wanted to tell me something.
Oh, yeah.
So a fart noise, that's all. Yep. Wow, that's really mature, Clyde. Is this really all... Look, I know there's something else. Juvie Bibble was almost crying when she told me that you had to say something. So just, what is it?
Nothing.
Clyde, please, stop it.
What? What is wrong with you? You used to laugh at my jokes and stuff.
Well, Clyde, that's when we were little kids. Times, they change. We're not kids, and... Can you please stop?
Sorry.
Times, they change. It's like when we're little kids. We're immature when we're little kids. We do fart and poop jokes. Then, we become teenagers. We're into that, pelvis-related stuff.
Pelvis!
That's exactly what I'm talking about, see? That's... I'm gonna be frank with you. I wish sometimes you would just be hardcore like us. You're so immature sometimes. Well, if you don't want to talk to me about anything, then I might as well leave.
What? But we were gonna have fun.
Oh, yeah. The narrator from Anchorman, starring Will Ferrell, once said, "The times, they are a-changin'." Of course, the narrator got that from something else. But Clyde didn't even know the meaning of that phrase. But what he didn't know is that there was a huge change coming his way. A change which would change his life forever. A change which would change his relationship with Blaze and Juvie Bibble. A change that could even change the world. A lot of stuff was about to happen that week.
Hey, Blaze.
Hey, Clyde. Listen, I want to apologize for the way I acted the other day. It wasn't right. I only acted that way because... Juvie Bibble has been acting weird. It's almost like she wants to break up with me. What is it?
Blaze, I can't tell you this anymore.
What is it?
Juvie Bibble asked me to tell you...
Clyde, what is it?
Juvie Bibble wanted me to tell you that she wants to break up with you.
No. Can't be.
That's what she said. I'm so sorry, Blaze.
I can't believe this. Clyde, I gotta go.
Are you gonna be okay?
I don't know.
But I'll see you later, okay? Bye. I want to get out in the world and do stuff. I don't want to be cooped up here just because you don't like going places.
What are you talking about?
Come with me.
Look
out here, Blaze. Look, there's a whole world out there to explore. And every time we try to go on vacation, at least once a month, you're always like, "No, let's change our minds. We don't want to go." I'm like, "Why?" And you're like, "Because I would like to stay here instead." You keep me from doing stuff. You, because I'm dating you, you always keep me from doing the stuff that I like to do. Well, I just, no, I don't want to hear it. It's like you're keeping me, listen, it's like you're keeping me trapped. Okay, I want to go out into the world and do stuff, but you're holding me back. But I don't want to lose you, though. It's like every time you come over to my house, you're always playing something else, like video games or something. Or you're talking to Clyde or something. You know what? Clyde actually likes going out into the world and doing stuff. He doesn't leave me cooped up at his house, just... No, he actually likes doing stuff. What are you saying? You're going to... Let me get this straight. You call me all the way over here just to tell me that you're gonna take Clyde, huh? Is that what it is? First of all, you came over by yourself without calling me. Second of all, yes, I might actually be dating Clyde now. Does he know about this?
No, but he will.
I'm just tired of this. Jimmy Bibble, I've been nice to you. I've been really nice to you. And this is the payment I get?
Blaze! How dare you use that tone to me?
No! Listen! I've been nice to you all my life!
Blaze, I want you to get out. Now. Get out.
Hello? Yeah? Who is this? The Tom Cruise? You're kidding me! Hello? Yes, what do you want? You want me to join your church? So let me get this straight. You're just out doing on one of your movie sets, just asking random people to join your church. Yeah, I'll come. Yeah, woohoo. Yeah, I'll do that. Yeah, yeah. I get to meet Tom Cruise. Yeah. That was the weirdest church I've ever been in. It didn't even seem like a church. It seemed like some... I don't even know. But, yeah. Hey, Blaze. What are you doing here?
Nothing, Clyde. I just want... Congratulations. Jimmy Bibble wants to date you.
Wait, hold on. She what? Hold on, wait. Wants to date me?
Yeah. So, congratulations.
You're kidding me. Wait, you seem to be taking it very well.
Yeah, I'm actually taking it pretty well. I'll be right back.
Hey, why are you holding that?
Oh, just a little present for you. You stole my girlfriend from me. Now I'm gonna kill you. And him.
Blaze. What are you doing here?
I was just leaving. I hate you, Clyde. I hate your guts, and I hope you die. You stole my girlfriend from me. Well, let's see how you like it when I get back at you.
Oh, man.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'm sorry, this was all my fault.
No.
It's mine. But he just... he needs time to think. He needs time to cool off.
Yeah.
So... you want to get back together?
I sure do.
Let's go.
Oh, I can't believe it. I can't believe this has happened to me. JP Bibble's gone. He's back with... JP Bibble? Come in! Jibby, is that you?
Greetings, young Sawyer. My name is Platt. And you know someone of mine. Who are you, and what are you doing here? Well, you see, I am a Scientologist. My name is Platt. And you know someone of mine who briefly went to my church, but then they walked out. I don't know who you're talking about. You see, he's got a police outfit. He wears a police hat. You know, kind of has black hair. Wears a tie. You know, I might know a guy named Clyde. And he is my arch enemy. Great.
All right, Clyde, I'm coming.
Oh, this blanket's warm. Yeah, I put it in front of the heat vent so that it'd get warm.
Ooh, I like that.
So you like it?
Oh, I love it.
Yeah.
So, what do you want to do?
Stuff. Giggity.
Did you just say giggity? Did you just quote Family Guy?
Yeah, have you ever seen Family Guy? You should watch Family Guy. It's funny.
Dude, I've already seen all 19 seasons.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I have.
Oh.
The only thing I haven't seen is Stewie's untold story.
Ooh, actually, hold on, I'll be right back.
Okay.
Where is it? It's here somewhere. There it is. Boom. Check this out. It's hard for me to pick up.
Oh, you actually got it.
Yep, I got it at Vintage Stock.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, maybe we could watch that tonight.
Yeah.
So,
you wanna get things on?
Giggity. Oh, come here. I heard a knock. Hold on. Hold on, I heard a knock. I'll go check it out.
I was tangled in the... Yeah, okay.
Hey, is this Clyde?
Yeah, I'm Clyde.
Okay, so, you went to a church a few weeks ago, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I just wanna say good luck. And that, $10,000 have been stolen from your bank account.
Wait, what? Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
What are you doing?
Oh, nothing.
So, who was that?
Oh, I don't know. I think it was someone pranking me. They said that I got, like,
money stolen out of my account or something, like $200 or something.
Oh, really?
Hold on, Clyde. Tell me if I misunderstood that guy or something, but did I hear him say something about you joining the Church of Scientology?
No, I don't think it was Scientology. I never even heard of that before. It was like Scienceology, that's what it was.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Alright, well, you're a really busy guy.
I'm about to get even busier.
Oh.
Wait. Did I just see Blaze out that window?
What?
I'm pretty sure I just...
Wait, you saw Blaze?
I'm pretty sure I did.
I'll go look. It's probably something to do with me. I'll be back.
Alright, be safe.
Blaze? 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 What are you doing?
Oh, nothing. It's just something personal.
Then, why are you here at Clyde's house?
Well, I was gonna, I was gonna come to see you, but I remembered about last night, and I was like, oh no, she doesn't want me, so I was gonna leave.
Is that what this is about?
It's just... I want you to come back, J.B. Bibble. I would do nothing to harm you. And I want you to be happy. J.B. Bibble, believe me. I would do nothing to hurt you or Clyde. Nothing.
You tried to kill Clyde. You think that wouldn't hurt me?
I just... I'm so sorry. I never meant to hurt you.
Blaze, listen. All you have to do is just apologize, and everything will be okay. That's all you need to do.
You know what? You're right. I just need to apologize.
Yeah.
Oh, damn, I need to call off the hit.
Wait, what? What hit?
Well, you see, me and these guys kind of teamed up to whack Clyde, and... Yeah. But the thing is, these people were apparently already after Clyde before they even met me. You see, apparently he joined the Church of... Oh, the Church of Scientology!
Wait, what?
Come on, Jimmy Bibble, we gotta get back.
The church...
Wait, so let me get this straight. You joined Tom Cruise's church and then left the church?
Yeah.
Don't you have any idea what you have done? Tom Cruise, he goes to a church, but it's not a real church. It's called the Church of Scientology. You see, once they leave your church, they will harass you. They will harass you, and they will not stop until you are dead.
Your fly's down. Okay, so what you're saying is if I leave the Church of Scientologists, they'll just harass me for the rest of my life until I die?
That's pretty much what they do, yeah.
But how do they know where I live?
That's the other thing, Clyde. You see, they may have met up with me yesterday, and I kind of told them a lot about you.
I'm a horrible friend. Heck, I said that you were my arch enemy. I'm so sorry, Clyde.
It's okay.
I mean, come on. You've done things like that too. Remember when I touched your eye?
All right. I dare you to touch my eye. Huh, this is actually gonna be pretty easy.
There, I touched your eye. Clyde? Clyde? Clyde?
You did touch my eye.
Just a family trip. Just all three of us.
That might not be a bad idea. What do you think, Jibby Bibble?
Not a bad idea.
Well, see you next week, Clyde.
See ya, Clyde.
I'm just kidding. You will never be rid of me. Tom Cruise? Tom? Tom? Mr. Cruise? Is that you? Cruise. He hung up on me. Well, I guess that's how life goes. Come in.
Hey, Clyde.
Hey.
So, what's up?
Well, I just got the strangest call. I think it was Tom Cruise. He said, "You will never be rid of me."
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I got a little surprise for you.
Really? What?
Come with me.
Hey, you people right there better stop fast-forwarding right now. Now let's continue the movie.
Come take a look, Clyde.
You. Thank you.
Yep, it's our baby. The judge said that he has taken away all restraining orders, which means you can be around him.
I haven't seen him in such a long time. Oh, it's been a while since I've seen him. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Come on. Come here, little baby.
Enjoying these comedy golds right now? Well, don't worry. We'll get better with... Okay, can you zoom out a little bit? Thank you. Okay, so we'll get back... Hold on. Point it down. Okay, you know what? Let's just get back to the movie, right? Alright, let's just go... Let's go back to... Okay. Just cut the camera.
Can we please just get back with the program? Look, we have like 45, we have one more hour on this movie still, and I want to get this movie over with so I can get paid, alright? Alright, so...
Wait, you're not Clyde.
Oh, right. Hold on, I'll... Wait, this is Clyde's scene?
Yeah.
Oh. Take two, everyone.
And we're rolling. Alright, so, I've been checking out the maps, and... We want to get to Florida. We take Interstate 70 to all the way to St. Louis, take Interstate 64 to 24, and then all the way to Chattanooga. And you know how the traffic is there, always bad. We go through Chattanooga, then take 75 all the way down through Atlanta, Interstate 10, and then Interstate 95. And then we're home free. Did you say three? Free. Right? Sounds like a good idea. Right. So, yeah. We leave next week. Monday. No. Thursday. Yeah, Thursday. Because Super Bowl is on. Monday. Yeah. Anyway. Yeah. Cool. Oh, my arm. Right. So, let's go. Yeah.
What's up, my triggers? Trigger. Wait, there's only one? Where's Jibby Bebble?
Oh, she's on her way.
Oh.
She's on her way.
Oh, okay. Well, do you wanna... Where's your stuff?
Oh, I'm getting it ready. Hold on.
Clyde, all you have in here is a shirt with a blood stain on it and some old underwear.
Yeah, I have clothing at my house, you know, back on Marriott Island.
Marriott Island is still, like, 24 hours away, and aren't we gonna stop at a hotel on our way there?
Yeah, but, I mean, we can sleep in the nude, giggity.
You know, I'm not even gonna ask why.
Hey, Clyde. Oh, hey, Jibby Bebble. How are you doing? Good, so, we're getting ready to go? Yep. Where's Blaze? Oh, he's here somewhere. Here, I know how to get him out. Watch this. What are you doing? Just watch.
Spring.
That is so odd.
Yes, and look at this. I got me a blaze.
Ow! It's a medical condition.
Sure it is. We're finally getting the house. We will continue all the way down to San Antonio. Sounds like the plan. You know, San Antonio is not too far from my lake house, Lake Hills, Texas.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Good night, Jibby Bebble.
Good night.
Ugh. Ow.
Smells like egg.
Hey, Clyde?
Yeah?
Look at this.
I know. It's been malfunctioning for 3 hours, so for some reason...
No. It's not malfunctioning. It's correct.
No, it says we're in Nevada. That's not right.
Oh, it's not right? Look out the window, Clyde.
Oh, that But I thought we were in Texas. We were in Texas, but now we're in Nevada. How could that be? I don't know. Well, I guess that just adds more on our road trip time. Let's go. Get the computer.
Wait a minute. Let me get this straight. Your father is still alive?
Why is it so surprising that I have a father? Yes, I have a dad.
What about your mom?
She's the only person I don't know about.
So you don't know if she's alive or not?
No. No, I don't.
Oh. But you have a dad and you never told me?
Yes, I have a dad. It's not... Okay, who do you think pays for my house? Who do you... Look, he's the one that pays for my house. Because, you know, I can't own a house by myself, so he makes it where I can live by myself.
But it doesn't matter. You can't live by yourself. It's illegal.
Yeah, well, my dad pays for it, so I can live by myself.
No, you can't. You're under 18. You can't live by yourself.
Oh. So I guess I still need to keep it a secret from the police, then.
Yeah.
Wait, you're under 17, too. Well... Man. Wow. I can't believe Austin, Texas got a lot of snow. Look at all that.
Wow, Austin, Texas never gets this much snow. In fact, they don't get any snow at all, don't they? I mean, do they?
Go on, Clyde. Your father's waiting for you.
You're right. I'm going. I'm going. Hey, son. Come on in. It's been a while. Yeah. So, how have you been? I've been busy, but other than that, I'm doing okay. What about you?
I'm doing fine.
Look, now is not really the right time for you to really come over. I'm really busy at the moment.
Well, we haven't seen each other in 2 years. And we didn't even talk to each other then. We were in the store, and we saw each other. And we waved at each other, and I came to talk to you, and then you were gone.
I know, but it's you're gonna have to go, okay?
Wait, but I have questions. Wait, what about Mom? Where's Mom?
Oh, Clyde. I don't know how to tell you this. But she...
Clyde. I have to do something, okay?
But, Dad...
Look, you gotta go.
Come on.
Now's not really a good time. I'm sorry, Clyde, but... Just, you gotta go. Who are you and what are you doing here?
I'm here because I have a few questions about your son.
I haven't seen my dad in 2 years, and I haven't even talked to him for 7 years, and this is how he reacts to me?
I'm sorry, Clyde. We should have known.
We're here for you, buddy.
Hey, listen, I'm not gonna let my father ruin this day. We still have a whole trip ahead of us. We could just continue our trip to Florida, that's all. Just continue.
I didn't know your house was so big and fancy.
Thank you. Yeah, I've lived here for a long time. Hey, Clyde, someone's calling me. Do you have, like, a back room or something that I could use? Yeah, there's one down that way.
Okay, thank you.
Anyway.
Hello? Hello? Ah, that's funny. I could have sworn I heard my phone go off. Who are you?
So, this is Clyde's house. Not bad, Clyde. Not bad at all.
What are you doing here? Who are you?
Listen up, white donkey. I want you to do something, all right? And if you don't do it, I will shoot you. I have a gun. So, here's what I want you to do.
The beach.
Let's go.
Wow, this is really fun, man. Wait. Who are you? What are you doing here? Blaze?
Yeah?
What are you doing here? I thought...
I'm building a sandcastle.
I thought you were someone else. Where have you been? I thought the other guy was
making a sandcastle.
Well, okay. Wow, this is really fun, man. I'm really getting a lot of tan.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah, I'm getting a lot of water. All right. Well, yeah, this is fun.
Yeah.
Mermaid. You see that mermaid over there? A mermaid.
Wow, that's a mermaid.
Hey, mermaid.
Hey. What are you doing here?
So, what do you like to do? Like, what do you eat and stuff? So, do you even talk?
No, I don't think
do you even? No, I didn't even talk like it.
Yeah, let's go. My sandcastle!
Oh no, your sandcastle! The mermaid. I think the mermaid did it. The mermaid. Let's go talk to the mermaid. Let's go. Let's go talk to the mermaid. She did this. Let's go. Hey, mermaid, you destroyed our sandcastle. We're leaving you here. We're gonna leave you here. Alright? Alright, next up, our house. Should be people, I'm back. Hey, sorry, but me and Blaze went to the beach without you. And then there was this some hobo sitting next to me. I mistaken him as Blaze or something. But, sorry for going to the beach without you.
Hey, Clyde. Can you please be a deer and pick up that knife on the ground?
What knife? Oh, why?
Come on, Clyde. Don't be a fork in the back.
What?
Pick up the knife. I bet you wouldn't go to someone and just stabbing them in the back with a fork, would you? Please pick up the knife.
Pick up the knife.
Please pick up the knife and turn around.
Okay.
Now turn around. That's good. Now close your eyes.
I'll do this.
Perfect, Clyde. Clyde. Clyde, call the police.
Not after you're done doing what you were doing.
Clyde.
Okay, Jimmy Bibble, what is going on? What? Oh no.
No.
Blaze, you think I did this?
You're a monster, Clyde. You're a monster. You killed Jimmy Bibble. You killed her. I'm gonna call the police, and I'm gonna make sure you die.
Clyde, I suggest you run before it's too late.
You killed her. And now, I'm gonna kill you. Clyde. Clyde, get back here.
911, what's your emergency?
I gotta go back to Kansas City, Missouri. Or someplace where they won't suspect me. Here, they won't expect me to go back to Missouri just after I arrived in Florida, will they? No, they can't. They can't.
Alright, guys, I know I said I called off the hit, but, I mean, Clyde killed my best friend. So, he killed Jimmy Bibble, so he deserves to die. So here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna have the police do all...
Hey, Clyde!
What?
We're behind you.
Huh? Oh, alright. So here's what's gonna happen. The police are gonna show up, and instead of telling them the story about Clyde killing Jimmy Bibble, because usually, if it's just like one murder they've committed, the police will be like, oh, they're just kids, they don't know any better. And then after a while, they'll just give up on the operation. They'll just stop searching for Clyde. So, if we say something like, oh, Clyde's like a terrorist. He's gonna kill the president. Actually, no, worse. He's gonna bomb America. And if we say that, then maybe they'll be like, oh, we gotta stop this kid. So, my plan is, Clyde deserves to die because he killed my best friend. So, here's the plan.
Hello? Yes, this is Police Chief Bob.
Listen, sir. We just got some news. We talked to this guy named Blaze. Apparently this guy, this Clyde character, is going to bomb the U.S. and we need to stop him now. Now, at first, we just thought, oh, it's just a murder. It's not a big deal. But this is actually, I think it's bigger than we think. Now, there are three major cities that we think he went through. So we talked to Blaze, Melbourne, Florida, San Antonio, Texas, and Kansas City, Missouri. We think he went back to Kansas City, Missouri. So, let's get right on it and be on our way to those major cities. And if you find him, shoot to kill. I repeat, shoot to kill. This kid is a terrorist.
You heard him, boys. Shoot to kill.
Oh, man. I can't believe what's happening. I am all over the news. Everybody thinks I'm a terrorist. I would never do something like that. I was framed. Or something. It's been 5 days. I can't even go outside. Because if I do, then someone will see me. Oh, man. Maybe some liquor will kill some of my brain cells. Liquor bottle. That's fizzy. Whoa. Wow. Oh. Oh, man. Wee. I gotta do something on my own laptop. Yeah. Nude selfie. No, I just gotta post it on Facebook. Done. Yeah. Yeah, we talked to a lot of people. Not even Clyde's dad knows where Clyde lives. And we tried talking to Blaze, but I mean, he knows where Clyde lives, but he doesn't remember the name of the street, city, or state, apparently. So that's not much help. And we don't know who else to call. Hang on a minute. Holy crap, I just found someone on Facebook. Dude. It's a nude selfie of Clyde. The house that he's in. I used to live in that house. I used to live there. I know exactly where that's at. Okay. Call back up. Call back up. And tell them to bring a lot of TNT. Oh, crap. Doing it. I gotta hide. I gotta hide.
Clyde? Clyde? Listen, the police didn't want to come with me. They thought maybe it'd be best for me to just go by myself because they have more important things to do, but... Are you there? I can't see very well.
What is this? Ew. Slimy. Alright, I gotta take this off. Ugh. Ugh. Oh, I need a mirror. That's much better. Oh, that's much better. I need a mirror. Some kind of mirror to look at. Oh, there's one. I'm good. I'm all good. Alright. That's good. My eye is better. Still can't see straight, but it'll do. Wait a minute, that's Clyde's shirt. Huh. It's not warm. Yeah, it's not warm, which means he hasn't worn it in a while. Aw, man. I don't think Clyde's here. I'm gonna have to go somewhere else. I'm just gonna go. Huh, man.
He's gone. He's gone. No. I don't know what I'm gonna do. Oh man. My life is ruined. Oh man. I have to hide everything. My shirt. My socks. My laptop. The baby. Oh, crap. I gotta hide.
I'm in the house. Looks like there's a box of stuff on the bed.
And a baby. Oh, man. Clyde left a baby in here. Here, take the baby. Take it to the ambulance. Make sure it's all right. Take it to the hospital and do all your stuff. All right, yes, sir. All right. Looks like we got a laptop. It's got a password. Forget it. Forget it. Got socks. And his police uniform. Okay. That's all. Come on, let's search around the building. Quick, there's his wallet. Search his wallet. See if you can find his driver's license. Really? Who doesn't have a freaking phone? Seriously, who doesn't? Do you hear something? Came from over here. There's some kind of note. Oh, guys. I know where he is. He's in the forest.
Well, but how do you know?
How do I know? Because this is why. One, make the officers think that I'm hiding in the forests. And I did. I wrote a note saying, do not search the forest. And of course, that of course is reverse psychology. If I say that I'm not hiding in the forests, then the officers are gonna think that I'm hiding in the forests. So I wrote them a letter saying, don't search the forest. And they, of course, think that I'm in the forest. So they went to the forest to search for me. And while they're busy doing that, they're too busy to search anywhere else. So that gives me the chance for step two. Sneak all the way back to Kansas City. And I just did that. Alright. So all I have to do is just live a happy life. Just happiest life in the whole world. And never be spotted by the police. Never. This will work out smoothly. Shit. Oh, no. They know I'm here. It's my only chance. What a mess in here. No sign of Clyde. Is there any other officers out there? I think I found our target.
Hello? Yeah, this is him? Yeah, what about him? He's innocent?
Now, son, you know what this thing is? Well, this ain't no stick. It's a gun designed to look like a stick. The truth is, I invented it, and you're the first person to be shot by it. Will be the first person. Leave me alone. I've waited my whole life to save the country. I've waited my whole life to take down a supervillain such as yourself. And that's what I plan on doing today. So how about, you either jump or I gotta shoot you. Please, leave me alone. Make your choice. I didn't do anything. Please. No, 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 no. No, no. Say your prayers, Clyde. Longer I can hang on to this rope.
Wait. Sir, you gotta listen to me. That Clyde's innocent. He's not the real criminal.
No. You are. You've been working with this criminal for how long?
No, he's innocent.
You know what? It doesn't matter now. Cause I got the dynamite.
No, sir, please wait.
Strength of dynamite is always an answer. Should have blown you guys up a long time ago. I should have known this was gonna happen. It's just a matter of time now. Soon, this whole ridge will be blown to smithereens.
Oh, damn. Clyde, come on, we gotta pull you up. Come on. Clyde, are you still there? Clyde? Oh, no. No. Please, still hang on. Oh, thank God. Oh. Clyde, come on.
Hello? What? Wait. Clyde and Blaze are innocent? You found the real criminals? Mr. Plate? I don't know who that is. You mean all this time? Oh no, what have I done? Guys! Run!
Use the TNT!
It's too late! You gotta run for it! I'm sorry!
Ah, crap.
Which way do we run?
I don't know. This.
Oh, man. Clyde? Clyde! 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 Oh, God, no. Oh, Clyde. Oh, Clyde, come on, wake up. Clyde, come on, wake up. Look, you were right. No, don't die. Clyde! No! Look, you were right about everything. You're not the criminal. I know the truth now. Please, just please wake up. Please. I know you didn't kill Jimmy Bibble. Please just wake up. Oh, no. No. I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
I now know the truth about everything. I know you're innocent. And I knew who the real I know who the real criminal is.
It's okay.
Wow, look at that.
The explosion really did a number on that land.
Yeah. Wow. Hey, let's go home, huh?
Yeah, let's go home.
What are you still doing here? The movie's over. You can go home now. Oh, you're waiting to see if there's a post-credit scene about Jibby Bibble, huh? Well, the truth is, the actor who plays her, Alice Lexis, happens to be out of town for a few weeks, so I'm afraid that's not possible. Well, just go home. There's no need for you to be here. Just go. Just go.